Good morning, I'm Dr. Sarisha, Associate Professor of English from Nalana Simhareddy Education Society's group of institutions. Today, we're going to learn the third unit from the textbook English for Engineers for First BTech English. The third unit's name is Blue Jeans, Unit 3. In this, we are going to study vocabulary, grammar, reading, and writing skills. So under vocabulary, prefixes and suffixes, and use of foreign languages, words from foreign languages, grammar, misplaced modifiers, tenses, under reading, skimming and scanning technique, and under writing, nature and style of sensible writing, definite writing, and many other things we are going to learn from this lesson or unit, Blue Jeans. So what is the life, the blue jeans, how did blue jeans emerge? All these things we are going to study in this lesson. How they were invented, they in the sense blue jeans. Denim cloth has an unusual history. The name comes from denim, what we are using as jeans material now, has an unusual history. The denim name has come from Serge de Nimes, a city in southern France. So this denim, what we are using, that name has come from Serge de Nimes. It is a city, it seems. It's a city, name of a city in southern France. Originally, it was a strong material made from wool. By the 1700s, it was made from wool and cotton. In the beginning, it was a strong material which was made from wool. It was only made with wool, but in the 1700s, people started making it with the wool as well as cotton. So first it was started with wool, and later it has become, people started making this denim cloth with wool and cotton. Only later was it made solely from cotton. So solely means completely, only from cotton. Originally, this material was used only to make sails, but eventually some innovative Genoese sailors thought that such fine, strong material would make great fans. So this material was, in the beginning, originally, if we have to speak about originally, in the beginning, it was made, it was used only to make sails. Sails means, you know, on ships, what, we used to keep a piece of material extended on as a mat to project, to stop the wind and to move the boat or ship. We put it as a sail. If I have to speak that in Telugu, it is called terasapa. Terasapa, I think that is the exact word. So it is called sail. So in the beginning, this was made only for sales. This denim was used to make sales, but some Genoese sailors, the sailors only, those who were sailing in the ship, they thought when they could use this such a good material for sail, why can't they use for a beautiful and great pants? Blue jeans in the form that we know them today did not come about until the middle of the 19th century. What we know, the blue jeans, what we wear, it has become trend of the entire place, entire on among youth. It has become not only youth, old, everyone, they wear this, women, men, everyone. So this has not come, this shape has not come until the middle of the 19th century, it seems. Levi Strauss, an enterprising immigrant who happened to have a few bolts of blue denim cloth, few bolts in the sense, some packs of blue denim cloth, recognized a need for strong work pants in the mining communities of California, mining. So Levi Strauss thought he had some bolts of blue denim cloth. He thought that this cloth can be used to make strong pants for mining workers, because they work in coal mines and other places. That will be helpful. Those people, especially for the mining workers in California, for them it can be strong. He first designed and marketed Levi's in 1850, and they have stayed essentially The same, even since there have been only minor alterations to the original designs. So this denim was made for this people in 1850. From the time, there were no more modifications have been done for that, and this have remained the same with slight modifications in that. The original levis did not contain rivets. Rivets means bolts, what we have for blue jeans. So original levis did not contain them, it seems. A tailor by the name Jacob Davis invented riveted pants at the request of a miner who complained that regular pants were not rugged. It's not R-U-G-G-D, G-G-E-D. People pronounce it as rugged, but it's wrong. It is rugged. Rugged means a hard surface. So regular pants were not rugged enough to hold his mining tools. So one man named a tailor who was namely Jacob Davis, he invented this riveted pants, it seems. Why did he happen to invent this? Means a miner, he complained, it seems. What did he complain? A miner means a person who works in a mining company. He complained that these pants, these pants are unable to make fur. These are not rugged enough. Means these are not, they can't stay. They can't stabilize. They can't be used in the hard surface. He said that, it seems. To hold his mining tools, it has become difficult. He said, it seems. Davis subsequently granted Strauss the use of. Use of his rivet idea, which was patented on 20th May 1873. Patented means taken rights. No one can do that because it was patented by that man. Patent means taking by their own name, on their own name. Inventing something and taking it on their own name means it is nothing but patenting something. So with that idea, they have made this. A few other changes were made over the next century. Zippers, people pronounce it wrongly like jip, it's zippers. Zippers replaced buttons in 1920, and in 1937, the rivets on the back pockets were moved inside. In response to complaints from school boards that the jeans students wore were damaging chairs, and from cowboys that their jeans were damaging the saddles. Saddle means on horseback we put a material on horse, not on horseback, on horse we put that material and we sit on that. They're called saddles. So first, rivets were, rivets were there, and later they have removed that rivets from that blue jeans. Why? Because some school children, school authorities and cowboys complained, it seems. Due to that, their pants have been causing damage to their pants. So they were removed entirely from the their jeans were damaging their saddles. In the 1960s, they were removed entirely from the back pockets. Rivets have removed entirely from the back pockets. And raw materials used in making blue jeans. True blue jeans are made out of 100% cotton, including the threads used for stitching them. In the beginning, as we heard the history, from the beginning it was made in wool, then cotton and wool, then later solely in cotton. So this blue jeans made out of 100% cotton, including the threads used for stitching them, whatever threads which we use, all those things are made with the cotton. The most common dye means print, used in is synthetic indigo. The belt loops, waistband, back panel, pockets, and leggings are all made of indigo dyed denim. Other means all the essential parts of the jeans are dyed with indigo denim. Other features of blue jeans include the zippers, the buttons, the rivets, and the label, all these things. Rivets have been traditionally made of copper. Rivets, these are made of copper, but the zipper and the buttons are usually steel. Designers' labels are often rags made out of cloth, leather, or plastic. while others are embroidered on with the cotton threads. So these are important things about the raw materials which are used in making denim cloth. Now let us move to manufacturing denim cloth. In order to manufacture trousers means pants. We say it pant, but it is in English we should better we use trouser. In order to manufacture trousers, first the fabric has to, now we are talking about manufacturing denim cloth. First the fabric means cloth, has to be prepared. This is done in three stages. This manufacturing of denim cloth is done in three stages. First stage, preparing the cotton yarn, and the second stage, dyeing the yarn, and the third stage, weaving the yarn. Three stages to get to the original denim cloth, the cloth should undergo three stages. First one is preparing the cotton yarn, second one is dyeing the yarn. Dyeing means printing the yarn, and the third one is weaving the yarn. First stage, let us see the first stage, preparing the cotton yarn. There are several steps to be taken before the zinned means the cotton which is brought from the fields. Zinned cotton means that has been picked from fields and processed, becomes cotton yarn. The incoming cotton is removed from tightly packed bales, big bales means bigger packet-like things, and inspected before undergoing a process known as carding. So what is the first step? Several steps are taken to bring the ginned cotton from the fields, and then it is made into yarn. This yarn, this cotton is removed from packed bales, and it undergoes a process called carding. In this process, the cotton is put through machines that contain brushes with the bent wire teeth. So in the carding process, this cotton is put in the machines in the carding process, which has brushes with the bent wire teeth. These brushes, called cards, clean this and disentangle, straighten, and gather together the cotton fibers. At this point, the fiber are called slivers. So after doing all these things, after undergoing the process of carding, this particular cloth is called slivers. And other machines join several slivers together. Then slivers are then pulled and twisted, which serves to make the thread stronger. So this, to make thread stronger, this cloth will be called slivers, and these slivers are put together, and then they are twisted with other machines together. Next, these ropes are put on spinning machines that further twist and stretch the fibers to form yarn. This is the process of manufacturing denim cloth. In the manufacturing denim cloth, there are three processes. We have discussed about the first process, preparing the cotton yarn. Ginned cotton, which we have bought, which we get from the fields, it undergoes a process called carding, wherein in the machine they make that, and after that it becomes slivers, and all these slivers they put together, and they make many things. They make threads stronger. Then they put all these slivers in the spinning machine, but they further twist and scratch, and then they made these fibers to form yarn. This is about the first process in manufacturing denim cloth.